Today, I'm going to talk to you about a disease that affects an estimated 176 million individuals around the world from every background. It is misdiagnosed, misunderstood, and receives little awareness. That disease is endometriosis, and that statistic came from the Center for Endometriosis Care. I have dedicated my life to the research and education surrounding this disease, and I would like to pass that information on to all of you. This is a picture of me at the Worldwide Endo March that we do in Florida every year in Orlando. And then this is a picture of me and my boyfriend and me and my best friend in our endo awareness outfits. This is what I would usually wear. This is toned down for me, honestly. So today I'm going to talk to you about what endometriosis is, why it is misdiagnosed and misunderstood, and why it receives such little awareness. We'll start with what endometriosis is. According to the Center for Endometriosis Care, endometriosis is a disease characterized by the presence of tissue similar but not identical to the lining of the uterus found elsewhere in the body. Did you just turn off?
Yeah.
Should we restart?
I got this one.
You got that one.
Okay. This is what endometriosis looks like. As you can see, this is what tissue looks like without endometriosis, and this is what the tissue with endometriosis looks like. That's good. Some symptoms of endometriosis include chronic pelvic pain, infertility, painful urination, bowel movements, periods, sex, and so much more. These are just a few of the symptoms lists, and it actually lists some of the symptoms that it causes mentally for people because it has such a high impact on people's mental health. When you're in chronic pain all the time, that can happen. It also has a high impact on the people that are around them, your friends, your family, and your significant other. Unfortunately, endometriosis can only be diagnosed surgically, as it can't be seen on scans unless in very rare cases where you have a lot of it or you have something like endometrioma. So, as far as treatment goes, according to Dr. Sumervo at the Center for Endometriosis Care, several guidelines have been developed by various consortia, but controversy and uncertainty over the best practice of treatment remain. Ablation, which is burning the endometriosis, is the most common practice that gynecologists use. But it is Dr. Sumervo's opinion that laparoscopic excision, or LAPEX, is and should remain the standard of care. So, ablation burns the surface, which you can see here. Like a flamethrower to a flower, it would leave the root to come back and grow, because you're burning it. Whereas with excision, you physically cut out the root to remove the disease. Although this is the best and gold standard of treatment, which all specialists agree with, most gynecologists do not use this method. They use this method because this is what they learned in medical school. So this is what a laparoscopy looks like. They go in, there's a camera up here, and they look in your abdominal cavity, and then one of the tools they have in here actually cuts out the disease or burns it if they use the ablation technique. So the only problem with this is, even though this is the gold standard of treatment, there's still no cure for the disease. Even if you get it removed by a specialist completely, you still have a chance of a 15% recurrence, no matter who you are. So, now that you know a little bit about endometriosis, I would like to tell you why it's misdiagnosed and why it's misunderstood. According to Heather Gordon at the Center for Endometriosis Care, though often referred to as a menstrual disease, symptoms are not limited to painful periods, and endometriosis can be diagnosed in those who do not menstruate, including in hysterectomy or after menopause, among gender-diverse individuals, and even in rare cis males. So this means that it does not only affect women, it can affect men. It affects 176 million individuals worldwide. Unfortunately, people try to limit the diverse population that it affects by saying it only affects women, when in reality, it can affect everybody, which most people don't even know. And I guarantee you, most of you sitting here, if you've ever heard of it, attribute it to being a woman's disease, because that's what you usually hear. So, this can lead to misdiagnosis and misunderstanding when you actually come around to looking at the disease. Women's Health magazine states that the average patient waits 7 years for a proper diagnosis. And because surgery is the only concrete way to diagnose endometriosis, many doctors treat other potential culprits first. Because doctors are misdiagnosing and treating other potential culprits, they're essentially causing harm to their patients because they're not treating the root cause of their illness or their disease. Dr. Andrew Cook from the Vital Health Institute explains all too often there's a parent-child relationship between doctors and patients as opposed to an adult-adult relationship. This causes a disconnect between doctor and patient and leads to diagnosis delay, misunderstanding between the patient and doctor, and even misdiagnosis. diagnosis because they don't know what they're talking about or they don't know how to talk to a patient correctly. So, now that you understand a little bit about why endometriosis is misdiagnosed and misunderstood, I would like to tell you about why it receives such little awareness. There's a stigma around endometriosis being only a woman's disease, which already cuts out part of the population that doesn't want to learn about it. So I want to make sure that everybody knows that anybody can have this disease, and it is not limited to any diverse individual, anybody can have this. And there's a large stigma that it's just painful periods, and doctors think this too. They think that you just are suffering with painful periods, when in reality, people have chronic pain year-round from this disease. So I'm going to tell you some examples of two women that suffer with this disease. A woman by the name of Rihanna says that her doctor didn't believe the amount of pain she was in. And another woman named Louise would faint on a regular basis because of the pain. When she was at the end of her tether, she dropped her trousers in her GP's office to prove how bad things were. That is completely unacceptable. This doctor did not want to do the surgery. He wanted to do the scans. He wanted to do the blood work that did not show endometriosis, so he did not believe she was sick. She dropped her pants in front of this doctor so that he could see the blood and the pain that she was in to prove to him that she was sick. This is why awareness is so important in this disease, so that we can have women like this know that they can fire doctors like that, and they can find specialists, and they can get the surgery and remove the pain from their lives and find what they need. So, as you can see, endometriosis is a very common yet misunderstood disease. It is complex, it is misdiagnosed, it is misunderstood, and it receives very little awareness. But with the help of people like you, spreading awareness and information surrounding the issue, we can break the stigma. You can be the change in care for those that suffer with endometriosis. Now I'd like to invite everybody up here to grab a yellow ribbon, and you can walk around with that and spread some awareness for endo. And if you know anybody suffering, I have my business card as well. I'm a patient advocate, and I'd be happy to help them.